then we are going to start. Okay, I think we already know about what is the project-based learning. I think it is really learners creating meaning and reaching understanding level. But I think this is the curiosity somewhere starts. So we are starting from a question, a doubt, or a curiosity to know more. You start from a school or a class, from a teacher, or from the environment, or from the parents. Many, many curiosities are there. The student is going to ask some questions. How am I going to survive in real world? Because most of them, I am going to make this kind of things. And student asking, I heard students are asking, if I am learning this mathematics or this English, what is use of this in my life? Because the constructive classroom, that is, I am in a structured classroom. There is a syllabus, there is examination, there is an assessment. Student must go with that one only. So that is, student is asking, how can I survive in the real world if I am going like this? Another question is that, what can't school be more real? Why it can't come like this? So this is the basic system for any query. This is the basis for the growth of any intellectual, any student, any learner in the world, in the school, formal or informal education. It is happening everywhere else. So we are starting from here, okay? Then, a learning method, an approach that uses problem as a starting point or stimulus for the acquisition and integration of new knowledge. Because we know many, it never generated from vacuum, but it is from the vacuum of the brain of any person, there is a curiosity to know. That is why we are reading many books now. That is, the problem is started in the insight of a person. That insight is really used by the five senses. They began to know. That is why now I am speaking to you in English language or another language. We are showing something. Everything because of this kind of problem solving mind of any kind of person that we are telling out of box. Even we know, without out of box thinking, we can't create anything else. But even though we are not allowing students to go out of box, this is also going on in between. So a project, an assignment to find a solution to a problem through research. It is a scientific activity, that is the academic thing, of truth finding and conclusion is development with a rational argument. The key points are scientific activity, truth finding, rational arguments. These are the key points. In scientific activity, we are intend to do something. For example, the coronavirus. The research in finding a vaccine is going on very scientifically with an outcome. But the knowledge generated in the world is not based on that scientific study. But academicians are making some of the scientific activities, scientific studies. So with the rational, because they want to burn, this is because of this, with evidence. But the person already started for inventing something like that, or Wright brothers, Alexander Fleming, and every scientist has no scientific study. They are run with the whatever they write, that is insight says. So they, but after that one, we are going to find out some kind of rational arguments that is going on. Okay, that is going on. Okay. Then would you please share that idea? What it is? What, where we are going to start for a project work learning system?
As share for the ideas. Your explanation, yeah. As for your explanation, it is from a question, or it can also be from an inquiry or insight.
Okay.
And you're going to find the truth about it.
Yeah.
You're going to find more findings about it. and this is all done through research.
Meenakshi ma'am.
Thereby, you expand your knowledge.
Yeah. Hello, Meenakshi ma'am.
Sir, may I?
Okay, you go ahead, Gayatri ma'am.
Hello.
Yeah. Make share your idea. What is the project? Hello. Okay, Gayatri ma'am, please go ahead. I think they are also good.
Okay, projects are also teaches you how to live in the real world.
Let because the student to know skills. How to live in the real world.
No, it develops certain skills in him, knowingly or unknowingly.
Okay.
As projects is a hands-on experience or his own experience, he will be developing certain skills that will help in his real-life situations.
Okay.
Moreover, I think project-based learning, children experience it and they enjoy it.
Okay, that is one of the things. Okay,
that is my personal comment. They enjoy
okay,
it.
Okay, very good. Meenakshi ma'am, anything else? That is why they are also not.
Hello, yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm just switching over to my laptop, so that's why
okay,
I missed. You please continue, sir. It's taking time. Okay.
Okay, that is most important words are scientific activity, truth finding. And rational explanation.
Rational.
Yes, these are the three things of this one. Then what is, I want to know, are you doing a true project-based learning or just a project? Then only we can start the class in the proper way. Which one you want to know? Mm-hmm. A project-based learning or just to do a project for the sake of course? What are going on around us?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Gayatri ma'am, please go
yes.
through the important point, VG, PBL
yes,
pathway
exactly.
and traditional. Okay, please read it.
Mm-hmm. Should I read it loudly, sir?
Yeah, that is better, ma'am.
Or
that is better. Then only we are reading something aloud, we can also share some ideas, okay? Point by point.
Are you doing true project-based learning or just a project? The first is project-based learning pathway. Inquiry and instruction is student-led. That means student is a leader there.
Okay.
He is leading or he is in the forefront there. So shall I cover PBL and then go to traditional or should it be
whatever,
together?
As you like, you which recommend? Way you can, which is convenient to you. Okay.
Okay. But in a traditional way, it is teacher-centric, whereas in the project-based learning, it is the student who is the leader. Tends to cover more than one discipline, whereas in a traditional method, it covers only one discipline. Since in a project-based learning, you cannot simply concentrate on one single problem. As you go deep into one problem, certain other problems would come out and you may need the help of more than one discipline, not simply your subject or that topic alone. For example, should I say the example, sir, from my understanding or can
okay.
I go
okay,
through
okay,
the
okay,
readings?
Of course.
It was a project for the science exhibition. Students selected how to water the plants in a place where there's a scarcity of water. But from there, they went to collection of statistical data. They also went to find out what are the other methods of rainwater harvesting. From there, they also went to the different seed varieties which can grow in less water.
Okay.
I think it covers more than one discipline in that way. That is what
understood. Okay.
And whereas in a traditional project, you give one topic, student just concentrate on that particular topic and they write, it is just some writings, that is all. The real learning doesn't happen there. The real experience doesn't happen there. In project-based learning, learning is extended beyond classroom and has a public audience. Again, I would go to the paddy field and things. The children had to meet the panchayat president. The children met the villagers there. And they also submitted their report to the district collector of Anuppur. That is our place. Okay. So it was not the students sitting in a laboratory or in anywhere in the school along with the teacher, but they went outside. Now these three students will be able to meet the panchayat president for any, how they know how to go with it. Any person, this is how you work in a real life environment. So always project-based learning is outside. It is something beyond the classroom and has a public audience. Whereas in traditional, it always stays in the classroom itself.
Okay,
maybe
okay.
There would be discussions in the classroom with the teacher and the friends, but children can also publish what they have, the scientific record, report, what they have prepared to the agricultural department. Okay. So I'm sticking to that example because that is what I have experienced in my school.
Okay, that is good. That's good.
So, yeah.
I think everybody
students are given voice.
Yeah, that is okay. Everywhere, student is the most important part.
Yes, yes.
Because if they are allowing to take a problem, after the school, real life, they can find a problem easily.
Yes.
Otherwise not.
Yeah.
That is the way, because without any experience, school is to experience these kind of things. But I think for the pressure of this kind of system, we have no time. Time management is not there. That is it. Yes, now. Okay. That is my question to everybody. Whether you want to learn project-based learning or just a project to make a project, because many teachers want to make a project only for the sake of this finish. I think. Whatever we are developing in the academy also, we are going to develop how to make one project for 1 year to finish all subject including. It is also possible. It is also, that is 100% for the student's life, not for the academy point of view. Academy point of view means, now we are telling what is academy is only for kind of limitations are there for degree, for 1 year course, for examination, for assessment. It is other than that. It is for the life. That is what we are telling. So students are giving voice. Students are given a problem to solve, typically occur in group, ends with a final public product. Here end with a test only. That is the difference between test a product and the PBL. Attacking me, are you there? Meenakshi ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Meenakshi ma'am. Then another important point. Comparing project and project-based learning.
Often completed alone. Project and project-based learning.
Yeah.
Projects are often completed alone.
Yeah.
In project-based learning, it's completed in teams. That develops teamwork.
Yeah.
Project-based learning.
It is for
whereas
social life.
Here you are all alone. Yeah, social life. Collaboration,
yeah.
I think. Utilizes the teacher as knowledge dispenser. whereas project-based learning, the teacher is only a guide. Yes, sir. That explains the role of the teacher.
Okay.
In project are often completed by following the teacher's step-by-step directions. Whereas project-based learning, the student is a leader. He makes his choices within pre-app. Sir, I can only see up to there.
Okay, okay.
I think is it...
this side is
often
not visible.
Have one. I can only see up to three app.
Okay, I think three. Where it is? I think I will also going to start from there.
Third one.
Can you please read it? Or Meenakshi ma'am? Oh, they are not here.
Okay.
That is a project.
Sir, which point?
That is the point third.
Often have one right outcome. So
something
it's not that visible to me. I have facing.
Okay, sir. I'll read it.
Okay.
Project, it only has one right outcome, whereas unanticipated outcomes are there, and that is pleasantly surprising for the student. Unexpected outcomes will be there, one after the other.
Yes.
Then the child, because I think he can think out of the box there. He may think out of the box there.
Oh, there are chances.
And he can make his own choices. He may think out of the box. So there are results are unanticipated outcomes. So what do you say to that? Unanticipated outcomes.
I think whenever, that is by Alexander from his experiment with some kind of a tissue cultures. But he found incontrovertible charity. That is unexpected outcome. And that is the way he has invented penciling. Whenever we are doing, whenever we are talking each other, some unexpected new idea should come, generate in our mind. Hello, Meenakshi ma'am, can you please read? Come forward, because everybody should be active.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah, please, go ahead. Now, Meenakshi is usual style now. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
I'm visible, sir.
Okay, visible now.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
So please start from anywhere else which you want to go into revise, because we want to discuss it. Project and project-based, because we want to make some of the misconception about the project and project-based.
Yeah, sir. Actually, there is certainly a misconception in a project and the project-based learning.
Yeah.
Most of the teacher, I would say all of the teacher, majority of wherever I have worked and the teachers where I have worked with, whom I have worked with, they all think like giving a project is considered as a project-based learning. Like giving any of the model or whatsoever, they consider that as a project-based learning. And even I myself realized in my later stages of learning, actually there is a huge difference between project and project-based learning.
Okay.
So very well explained, sir, whatever the points you have written over there. And just would like to take a few minutes to say about it. Like as has been mentioned, obviously, they are often completed alone and completed in teams. But yeah, there is always a collaboration in project-based learning, and utilizes the teacher as a knowledge dispenser and as a teacher as a guide. Yeah, we give freedom to work in the project-based learning to the students, and in a team, even they explore, different channels.
Yeah.
Agree. Yeah, fine, sir. It's very well clear, and I would rather here it is written about the assessment and about the outcomes and all. Yeah, it is assessment occurs at the end. Yeah, when the final product is ready, occurs at the end, and occurs assessment is there in parts. When they are taking the different platforms to reach to the culmination level, then there is assessment at each level. Because there is a trial and error method also. When we try one method and we realize, okay, it is not working, let's go for another one. So that is again a learning. So I guess it's right, sir.
Okay.
Let's. Thank you.
Sir, I wish to add on to this.
Okay.
Sir, project, if I talk about project, it's the end product of learning. Whatever student have learned, they are going to apply that comes out.
Yes,
that
yes,
is what we call as project. It's an end product.
Yeah.
Whereas project-based learning, if I talk about, it is a continuous process.
Yes.
Where, as ma'am has said, the project which makes students learn through this continuous process.
Yes. That is yesterday we all concept that is discussed about us, the Gayatri means also is a concept. We can measure a concept in any scale now.
Yes.
The discussion is go so deep. That is why we are referring the book, everything, because of the conceptual learning and teaching and working is going on. That is why new idea is coming every day. There is new book. There is new one is there. But here, what are maybe end of the session, students should also finish this one. Finished means finished, pass, then go out. There is no scope for the role in the life. That is why I showed that the first two questions, please see this one. It may start from a question.
Yes.
How am I going to survive in the real world? That is a question of a child. What can't school be more really? Student is asking. Why can't it? What can't it? That is why a learning methodology we are up. That is an approach. Your two points are there. First is a scientific activity for truth finding with the rational arguments. The three points and keywords are most important. But I think all the inventions are been taken place not for scientific, because Newton never used the scientific method. Then it is emerged as a scientific method. But whatever the circumstances he want, he are taken everything else. That is it. 1 minute, please. I think you should also go with the discussion. Hello.
Hello, Rakhi ma'am. Have you undertaken any project like this in your school? Meenakshi ma'am, you too may
join. Right now I'm planning for one project-based learning. I already had this with the 9th grade. It will start with 9 to 12.
Okay.
Related with the science. And not only science, it incorporates all the subjects.
Right now
I'm working on that, and integrated project I'm planning. It is on two bases. One is short-term project, which can be completed within a month. And one is a long-term, which takes at least 2 or 3 months to complete.
Okay.
That is what is. I think short-term or long-term is not a this. What is the purpose? Then we can decide after, okay? Here are turned into the teacher and pro-grading. That is usually going on project. But based learning, product, performance, or service are presented to a public audience. This is the way I have prepared everything. And after 5 minutes, we are coming again, okay? For the same. I will give another link for you.
Okay,
that is it. That means also
sir,
there, okay.
Kindly send the password to you because it demands password.
Okay. Again, it will come like this. It is. Okay. Solve a fictional problem. Involve in the real world in which they solve a real world problem. Well, that is, we can also discuss more. So this is a cycle. Next one is the cycle. Project-based learning cycle. It will also elaborate. Don't try to write it because every point, the handbook is also prepared the same way. Don't worry about that. It will get. We can make mass discussion for that. And that is Meenakshi ma'am, that is handbook is ready. I will send to you. And that is Gayatri ma'am also, okay? Generate the idea.
Okay.
That is, I think it is 10 steps are there in the building.
Okay.
Building a background is one, and investigation second part, then presentation third part. In each part, there is each points are there. First of all, create a culture of inquiry and collaboration in the classroom. So make a checklist like this. It is generate idea, brainstorming. Every will come if there is a question to answer, otherwise no idea should come. So to what degree do I? Not at, sometimes frequent. That is, we are generating a culture of inquiry and collaboration in the classroom before starting any project. Model curiosity and questioning task. Talk, that is way. Value student curiosity and risk taking. Honor diversity of ideas, thought and actions. Because whenever the eyes of experience that one, sir, that is difficult, sir. How the students go to supermarket and collect this one? That is, I think, the risk taking. That is not a risk actually. So it will take much time to go there. How can we arrange the transport? You know, could you please arrange the transport? Then we can go. That the teachers are telling like this. Because they are not giving importance for that kind of things. They are giving importance for the sake of the course only. That is why we can't find any good, that is bright in our school. And provide choice. That we are also going to foster opportunity for students to question and test ideas. For example, the coronavirus. We can take the social aspect of this coronavirus now. Then we are going to select what is why. Kangori is also because one curiosity is that one. Whenever we are watching this newsletter, it is telling that 1,300 is affected. But the local is that one. In our place, it is like this. But the national, but everything is contradictory statements are going on. But I think whenever you also go into the Arogya app or anything, if it is not updated, we are getting older data. How do we solve it? That kind of curiosity should be generated in the mind of the child to inquire. That is the cultivating, create a culture of inquiry and collaboration in the classroom. First opportunity for student to question and test ideas. Okay, yes, now we are going to face a very big world of data. All the data are not relevant. How do you find the real data from the ocean of data? Again, inquire and test it. How do you test? That is the curiosity. For example, we are also going to tell tomorrow what is the job market. That only thing is we should inquire about the professional, not the careerist. So that is just a few seconds before, just Gayatri ma'am, I also discussed with her. Everyone is that is going for PSC coaching centers without knowing whether it is, because there are a few vacancies out there. So just why it is so? What are the real thing we should have? How many that is a human time and everything is going on? Or spending money, everything. Okay. Help students learn from their failures. That is then only this step, each step should be increased properly. Engage in ongoing discussion about the classroom and ground rules. Teach collaborative skills, nurture trust. We should inquire in this. This is the first thing, we should create a culture of inquiry. That is a motivation factor, everything is also there. Then can you please share your idea? How to create the culture of inquiry in the classroom?
Culture of inquiry, sir, by asking open-ended questions to them and not providing all the information to the students by the teacher, obviously, and making them some kind of giving them some kind of questions, like they should become curious. And as this ma'am started asking about a project and the project-based learning. Sorry, that time I right now like to mention something over here that will lead to inquiry as well. Like earlier, if I go back years ago in my classes when I was teaching about this, suppose the festivals of different states, maybe the food items of the different states, cuisines and all. What I used to do is, in my classroom only, I used to say all the students, okay, on a particular day, you all have to be, either you yes. can dress up as per a particular state,
yes.
or you may please bring the food of a different kind of state, dishes. And then we can. This was 30 years ago. And now slowly and gradually with the passage of time and having some of the sessions with you or maybe other facilitators, that has changed my mind also, and maybe with the help of experience as well. Right now, I am going to do some project and I want your input for that as also. Please guide me whether it is a project or it is a project-based learning. What I have, yesterday only I have talked to somebody, like I am working with the school in this Gurgaon right now. And I have got another project with some school in Uttar Pradesh. And basically, as I am from Punjab, there also I have got some contacts with the different schools because I have got my education from Punjab. I had a word with the school representatives of the schools of different states. I just interacted with them. I said, I want to have a project, maybe in class 8, there is a first chapter, crop production and management. And in the junior classes, in the primary grades, there is talking about the cuisines around the globe or whatever. Now, before going ahead globally, if we are talking about unity and diversity, why not to explore the different states first? So I have told, okay.
Okay. That is okay, ma'am. But I think whenever we are also going to make a culture of inquiry for learning, that is the most important thing, project-based learning or any learning system.
There should be a question.
Yeah.
How? Why is it?
Yeah. That we are going to discuss about that one. I think we are, that is
what
after.
Came yeah. Actually, when they are sharing their experiences. So So isn't it an experiential based, project based learning? What are your views, sir?
Yeah. I think whenever the project based learning is there, and the person is integrated, we can't do anything more than that. We want language. The language can be used in the class also, the same language. We some kind of measurement, statistics or something else. Without this, we can't do anything else. And we are going to some kind of other, all the science, because whenever we are going out of this kind of inquiry, many things will come. Sometimes we should also give some idea to the subject. Subject means the people we are going to do. The subject is asking something, we must to answer that. So not automatically we are getting more. But for the finishing of that particular PhD or whatever, maybe we should be in the line. That is all, because we want to prove that. That is only academic. But the non-academic area, we can go into consider everything else. So many branches will come. But now you are telling, I am thinking, why can't you think like this, For example, Meenakshi ma'am already taken the food. I think it, without this, we can't live here. So most important factor of the production unit is the agriculturist. No industry can exist here without agriculture industry. Okay, yeah, we can take a leave now. Then after 5 minutes, we can again enter. Okay, that is better. We can take a gap
so
or a tea break. Tea break.
Is it the same link? Is it the same link?
No. I will send another link. Yeah. I will send. Okay. Sure. Usually we are taking a tea break. That is the same one is going on here.
Okay. So please but kindly send the password.
Too. Okay, I will
send the password.
Okay. Usually you should click on that one itself. That is it will come. Okay. Then